Hi everyone, Period Help Australia here. Whoa, what is going on with the lighting? It makes this look red. That, whoa, hang on. What the? That is really weird. Okay, sorry if everything looks red. I don't know what's going on with my camera. But anyway, today I'm doing a video on the Moxie sleepovers pads. Are they sleepovers? Sleep time? Yep, sleepovers pads. Is that overnight pads anyway? Moxie only does regular and overnight pads, so it's not as if you'll be able to get their range confused very easily. This is what the packaging of one looks like, as Moxie always does. Very, very cute packaging, well-designed packaging. It's got a tab, and it opens very quietly. Listen to this. Okay, that wasn't quite as quiet as usual, but anyway, and it opens very smoothly as well, it doesn't tear, so I'm very fond of Moxie's packaging and what they do with that. This is what the pad looks like. Now, what you might notice immediately is it's quite narrow, quite thin, quite petite. To me, it just doesn't seem like an overnight pad. Like, when I think overnight pads, I think, you know, really broad protection. It's going to cover me really well, but this is quite narrow in the gusset, and I'm not sure if you can tell, but this pad is really thin too. So honestly, I don't trust these pads for my heavy nights. Also, because it's so narrow at the back, it like doesn't flare out much. On heavy nights, I'll normally use either a U by Kotex maxi pad, or I'll use a Stay Free one, because they go really wide at the back. Because, as you may be acquainted with the effect, when you lay down overnight, the blood flows back, and yeah, if you don't have a wide pad, it can make an absolute mess of your underwear. So I only wear these during the day, despite being an overnight pad, because I don't think that they absorb enough, and I just don't think that they're the right shape. That being said, they are very comfortable pads. I've got nothing against these as pads in general. I just don't think that they're suited to the purpose that they're advertised for. Like, they will collect menstrual flow, they are quite comfortable, although Moxie pads are never really the softest. But, you know, they're comfortable, they're cute, but they just don't work for overnight unless you've got a really light overnight flow. And if you've got a light overnight flow, then you're probably not going to be buying, like, overnight pads in the first place, because you can just use a regular or a super pad, which is what I do on the later days during my period. So I find that these are kind of a redundant product. Like, I don't need that little bit of extra coverage if my overnight flow is lighter, so I would just use a regular pad. But when I need a proper overnight pad, this one doesn't do the job. So, I don't know, my opinions are kind of mixed on these. I probably wouldn't buy them again, really, because they're just a little bit useless. It sounds like I'm trashing these products, and I'm really not, because they are good pads. They've just been kind of stupidly designed. And that's about all that I've got to say on these. I hope you enjoyed this review. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you soon. Bye!